Good morning. Today we'll discuss mining frequent patterns, association and correlations, basic concept and methods under which patterns are interesting. Here we are going to have the pattern evaluation methods discussions. Most of the association rule mining algorithm employ a support and confidence framework. Many of the rules generated are still not interesting to the user. Unfortunately, this is especially true when mining at low support threshold or mining for long pattern. When you go for mining data, there you have to fix minimum support and minimum confidence. There if you go and fix lower value of minimum support and minimum confidence, and of course the association rule mining will help you to find the frequent patterns. But if you go for some more maximum support and maximum confidence, that it will not help you. So in this section we'll see how even strong association rules can be uninteresting and misleading. And second, how the support confidence framework can be supplemented with additional interestingness measures based on correlation analysis. And third one is additional pattern evaluations measures. And finally, we'll discuss about the overall comparison of all the measures over here. Strong rules are not necessarily interesting. Whether or not a rule is interesting can be accessed either subjectively or objectively. When we have a rule, we don't think about the interestingness of the rule. We will automatically will try to use this rule either subjectively or objectively. Ultimately, only the user can judge if a given rule is interesting or not. So why? Because finally the rule can be used by any users. The user can only give a judgment about the rule whether it is interesting or not. And this judgment being subjective may differ from one user to another user. So one user may like something, the another user may like some other things. For example, a user liking coffee, they can go for bread also. But some other user liking coffee may go for some other product other than a bread. So user to user there may be some difference. However, the objective interestingness measures based on the statistics behind the data. So we already discussed, if you have a data, the data will have a statistical information. Without knowing the statistical information, it is very difficult to categorize the data. So here the objective interestingness measures, it is purely based on the statistics of a data. It can be used as one step forward to the goal of weeding out uninteresting rules that could otherwise be presented to the users. So it is very important, we need to remove the unwanted or uninteresting rules, otherwise it can be presented to the user as it is. Misleading strong association rule. The association rule can be very strong, it is giving very good result, but sometimes even though it is very strong, it may mislead the users. How can we tell which strong association rule are really interesting? Let's examine. Okay, here we'll take an example, computer games and videos purchase. So out of 10 transaction analyzed, the data shows that 6,000 of customer transactions included computer games, while 7,500 included videos and 4,000 included both computer games and videos. So from this data we can have the minimum support and minimum confidence. Now minimum support is 30% and minimum confidence is 60%, which is fixed by the user. By applying the formula, we will be able to calculate the support and confidence, which is taken from the derived from this example. Here the formula is bias of x comma computer games tends to bias of x comma videos. Here x is the person. The person purchase computer games may also purchase videos. So with this, if you apply these details over here, we'll be able to find out the support and confidence for this given data. Here, by calculating the support and confidence for this given data, we'll be getting support is 40% and confidence is 60%. This support and confidence derived from this example, if you compare with this minimum support and minimum confidence, it is greater than this minimum support and minimum confidence. So how it was calculated? So the above rule is a strong association rule and would therefore be reported, since its support value is 4000, okay, 4000 by 10000 equal to 40%, and confidence value 4000 by 6000 equal to 66%, which satisfy the minimum support and minimum confidence threshold respectively. Here we have taken 4000. Why? Because 4000 is a count shown for both video games as well as computer games. And the rule is misleading because the probability of purchase video is 75%. Probability of purchasing video is 75%, which is larger than 66%. Here we have derived only 66%, but in the example, it is given 75% of probability for videos. So it is misleading, even though it is very strong association rule many, and giving support and confidence greater than minimum support and minimum confidence, it is misleading. In fact, computer games and videos are negatively associated because the purchase of one of these terms actually decreases the likelihood of the purchasing the other one. From association analysis to correlation analysis, we know very well that association analysis is completely the framework of support and confidence. The support and confidence measures are insufficient at filtering out uninteresting association rules. So to tackle this weakness, we are going to have the correlation measures. A correlation measures can be used to augment the support confidence framework for association rules. This lead to correlation rules of the form. Here you can take item A and B. Okay. So if A tends to B of support, confidence and correlation, normally we will take only support and confidence. Here we will take correlation as an additional parameter over here. A correlation rule is measured not only by its support and confidence, but also by the correlation between item set A and B. Now for correlation measures, we'll take LIFT is a simple correlation measure that is given as follow. Here the occurrence of item set, if P of A union B equal to P of A P of B, then A is independent of the occurrence of item set B. Here A and B are item set. P is nothing but the probability over here. So probability of A union B equal to probability of A into probability of B, then item A is an independent of occurrence of item set B. Otherwise, item set A and B are dependent and correlated as a event. Here you can see the definitions. It is easily extend to more than two item set. For example, if the LIFT example, if you take the lift between occurrence of A and B can be measured by computing the formula which is given over here. Lift of A comma B equal to probability of A union B by probability of A into probability of B. So by using this formula, we'll measure the correlations in the lift examples. So in this, we have two different types of correlation. One is negatively correlated, another one is positively correlated. So one more is there is no correlation between item A and B. For example, if you take, by applying this previous formula, when you get the value based on the results, if the result value is less than 1, then the occurrence of A is negatively correlated with the occurrence of B. If it is less than 1, it is negatively correlated. That meaning is that the occurrence of 1 likely to lead the absence of other 1. That is the meaning. If it is negatively correlated, that means the occurrence of 1 likely leads to the absence of the other 1. And if the result is greater than 1, then A and B are positively correlated. What do you mean by positively correlated? That means the occurrence of 1 implies the occurrence of other 1. If you take items 1A, okay, it implies the occurrence of item B. And the next possibility is, third possibility is, if the resulting value is equal to 1, then A and B are independent. Okay. So in between, there is no correlation. So these are all the three possibilities when you find out the probability for A and B with respect to correlations. Next, correlation analysis using lift example. Here, how the two item sets A and B are correlated. With this previous example, you can see the probability of purchasing a computer game is a probability of game equal to 0.60, that is 6000, which we already discussed. And next one is the probability of purchasing video is 0.75, that is nothing but 7500. It is given in the example. Example. The next one is the probability of purchasing both is P of game and video. It is 4000. Here it is given 0.40. So according to the rule which is given already, okay, the formula is derived like probability of game comma video by probability of game into probability of video. So in this formula, if you apply this the data which is collected from this example, here 0.40 by 0.60 into 0.75, the result is 0.89. So the data which is taken from the table which is given below. So in the table, if you see that here left side video and not video and correlations, the top game, not game and correlations. Here if you take game alone, okay, it's a game alone, it is a 6000, the correlation is 6000. If you take not game, then it is 4000. The final correlation is 10000. It's a total data analysis. So if you in matrix, if you take video and game, if you take like this, okay, so matrix format, if you take video and game, then the value if you take both video and game, then the value will be 4000. If you take video and not game, then that will be 3500. Okay, so if you take video alone, the right side, it is given, it is a 7500. Okay, and if you take not video, okay, means you have game, that is a 2000. See, if you get some, you will get game alone. And same way, in not video, okay, not game, it is a 500. If you sum these two, then you will get 4000. Okay, the same way in the correlation also. Okay, so finally, with the 10,000 data, we are going to calculate the probability of game, probability of video, and probability of both. Okay, so by applying the formula, we are getting 0.89. The 0.89 is less than 1. So because this value is less than 1, there is a negative correlation, which we already discussed. If it is less than 1, it is negative correlations. Okay, so beta between the occurrence of game and video. Here game and video is a item set like A and B. The numerator is likelihood of the customer purchasing both, while the denominator is what the likelihood would have been if the two purchases were completely independent, like P of A into P of B, like that. So here P of game into P of video. So it is given like that. It is completely independent. Such a negative correlation cannot be identified by a support confidence framework. Simply, if you go for support confidence framework, you may not be able to identify the negative correlations. So if it is negative correlation, we have already seen the meaning for negative correlations. So next table is given. It is a contingency table. Here same table is given over here also. Only thing is, it is for game you have given 4000. Nearby we have given 4500. That is expected value. 4000 is observed value. 4500 is expected value. Likewise for everywhere we were given. And same way for 3500, we are given 3000 within the bracket. 3000 is observed value. 3500 is observed value, and 3000 is expected value. 500 is observed value, and 1000 is expected value. And 2000 is observed value, and 1500 is expected values. So with this observed value and expected values, we have a formula. If we apply that, then we'll get the values to find out the measures. Okay, so here you can take correlation analysis using correlation measures. To compute the correlation using correlation measures analysis for nominal data, we take the square difference between the observed and expected value, which is given in the table. The same table for your convenience, here also it is given. Okay, see, I'll read again. We take the square difference between the observed and expected value for a slot A and B pair in the contingency table, which is given below, and divide by the expected value. Here we need the observed value and expected value. Okay, expected value, it is given in the parentheses, for each slot of the conditions table, which is shown in the table. So again, you can have a look on table. Okay, 4,500, 2,500, 3,500, 3,000, 500, 1,000. Okay, so you must know what is the observed value, what is the expected value. What is the observed value, what is the expected value? What is the observed value for video, what is the observed value for game? What is the expected value for video? What is the expected value for game? So you try to observe these values and put it in the formula. By that you will have x square. Here the formula is given. Correlation measure equal to sigma observed minus expected whole square by expected equal to observed value is 4000 and expected is 4500. It is square and divided by expected. This concept is given in the descriptive manner in the previous slides. And plus same A for other one, 3500 minus 3000 whole square divided by expected value 3000. And plus 2000 minus 1500 whole square by 1500 plus 500 minus 1000 whole square divided by 1000 equal to, we are getting the result is 555.6. So this value is greater than 1. So because the correlation measure value is greater than 1 and the observed value of the slot game video equal to 4000, which is less than expected value. Okay. Why? Because the expected value is 4500. So it is given 4000. So less than expected value of 4000. Then the buying game and buying video are negatively correlated. This is consistent with the conclusion derived from the analysis of lift measures. Okay. So with this, we have found which patterns are interesting, how the patterns will be evaluated, what are the patterns evaluation methods we have discussed over here. So at this level, we'll stop this topic, and tomorrow we'll discuss the important questions which is there in the first unit as well as the second unit. Thank you.